By what name are you known?
There are some who call me Tim.
Welcome to another episode of Timmy Talks, the channel where we talk old school magic. And today we have an EC game for you. That means Eternal Central Rules. So we've got Mana Burn, we've got Four Strip Mines, we've got Fallen Empires. And it's kind of interesting because I am playing with my Eternal Central Mono Black Thralls deck. And I'm taking on a mono red deck, a mid-range deck, full of surprises, full of beautiful creatures, but I don't think it contains any Fallen Empires. I don't think, I guess it's just a Swedish deck, but I mean, whatever. So we'll just see how that is going to work out against each other. Now, before we are going to go to the actual games, we are first going to do a little deck tech like always. Now, if you want to skip that, you can check the description below. There you will find a timestamp. Click on the timestamp that says games begin, and that will take you straight to the actual games. Now, of course, if you want to hang around and join me for the deck tech, stick around, you know, it's going to be very interesting. I really like this red deck that I'm playing against today. But let's start with my deck. Let's take a look at the Thrull Pit. And here we see the mono black deck that I'm playing with today. I've called it the Thrull Pit after the Breeding Pit and of course all the Thralls in this deck. And as you can see, it's really an EC deck. I'm playing with four Hymn to Turex, obviously really strong, especially when you also have a Mind Twist. That's a lot of discard power. I'm also playing with Mindstep Thralls, by the way. It's a 2-2 for 3, so you could play an Hypnotic Spectre, yes. Would that be the better choice? Probably, but hey man, sometimes you want to play something else. This is a Thrall deck, so I chose to go for the Mindstep Thrall, and what it does is when it attacks, and if it's unblocked, you can choose to let it do 0 damage. Instead, you can sacrifice it, and then you can force your opponent to discard 3 cards. So it's actually pretty powerful if you can manage to deal some damage and if your opponent still has a full grip of cards. Now, I'm also playing with 4 Sinkholes and 4 Strip Mines. I really like that in combination with the discard, because if you can play Mana Denial, then your opponent will be unable to play out his or her cards, and then you can play your discard plan to make him get rid of all the other cards in his hand. So that's kind of, I really feel that land removal and discard strategies kind of go hand in hand, because he's stuck with a full hand, and then your Hymns and your Mindstep Thralls and your Mind Twists can actually do some damage. Now looking beyond that part of the deck, we also see Bat Moons, and we see 2 Breeding Pits. So Breeding Pit is a card, 1 black and 3, it's an enchantment. You gotta be 2 during your upkeep, 2 black, or else it destroys itself. But as long as you can keep it alive, on your end step you get a 0-1 Thrall. Now obviously, with a Thrall Champion and a Bat Moon, those 0-1 creatures turn into much bigger creatures, and I can start attacking my opponent with it. And another nice synergy here is the Soul Exchange and the Breeding Pit. So with Soul Exchange, it's a sorcery for 2 black, and you can sacrifice one of your creatures, remove it from the game, and in return you can take another creature from your graveyard and put it directly into play. And if you've sacrificed a Thrall in this way, that creature actually comes back into play with a +2/+2 counter. So in an ideal situation, I can sacrifice one of my 0-1 Thralls from the Breeding Pit to get back, for example, my Thrall Champion, which would then get a +2/+2 counter, and it also gives itself +1/+1. So it would all of a sudden be a 5-5. I can also get my Ebon Praetor back. I can even get my Lord of the Pit back. Talking about Lord of the Pit, I'm only playing one, but of course you can see that combination, Lord of the Pit, Breeding Pit, and also Ebon Praetor, Breeding Pit. So that's kind of like the more classical combinations in this deck. Now I'm also playing with an Ashes to Ashes, which I think is pretty kick-ass. A nice signed one, signed by Drew Tucker, of course, the artist, amazing artist. And I'm also playing with 2 Drain Lives and a Nevermore's Disc. You know, if it all goes wrong, I can at least blow up the whole board using my disc. And of course, I've got my Demonic Tutor, and that means that all these one-offs, like 1 Pestilence, 1 Nevermore's Disc, 1 Ashes to Ashes, 1 Lord of the Pit, you can all times them by 2 because of your Demonic Tutor. Because when you need them and you draw into the tutor, you can find them and you can play them out. So that's what I always really love about Demonic Tutor. It makes what they call in Magic your silver bullets. It makes your silver bullets much, much better, simply put, because of your demonic tutor. So this is my deck, the Thrull Pit. Now let's discuss, because I don't have a deck picture, unfortunately, but let's discuss the deck of my opponent, because he's playing some pretty cool cards. Let's take a look. And here we see a few cards of the deck that I'm playing against today. Now I've called it Disharmony and Friends because it plays the card Disharmony, one red and two. And this is such a cool card. The art is fantastic, but the card itself, it's pretty unique. It's an instant from Legends. And what it does, it says, target attacking creature comes under your control untapped. Return to former controller at the end of turn. This creature is no longer considered to have attacked. Play before defense is chosen. Now, the kind of unique thing about this is, of course, it's great in a combat situation. For example, your opponent I'm going to attack him with two Mindstep Thralls. He can play Disharmony, steal one of the Mindstep Thralls, use it to block my other Mindstep Thrall, and that way killing both of my creatures. But this deck has something even cooler going on because, you know, especially in old school Magic these days, you don't see a lot of creatures that attack at the same time. So usually it's just one creature attacking at the time. Well, the problem then is you can Disharmony it and you don't take any damage, but that's that. But what if you have lands or a sec? I should say, what if you have a sec output? And what my opponent Yup has done, he's added City of Shadows, Diamond Valley, and also Safe Haven in his deck. So Diamond Valley is a land you can tap, you can sacrifice one of your creatures. Well, with Disharmony, you've just taken over the creature of your opponent. It's now yours, so you can sacrifice it to Diamond Valley and you can get life. With City of Shadows, you can sacrifice it for a shadow counter that's basically going to give you mana. So it's just funny. You can just take over the creature of your opponent with your Disharmony that nobody sees coming. And then you can just get life, or you can get mana, or you can just put it in Safe Haven, put it in a cave, and it will never come back. It's just hilarious. And you know, besides this kind of Disharmony package, he's also playing with the usual direct damage. I would say he's playing with four chains, four bolts, and with some fireballs. But I think the real power of this deck happens in late game. So in late game, he's going to start playing really big creatures. He's playing with Shivan Dragons. He's playing with Rock Hydras. He's playing with Two-Headed Giant. So basically what he wants to do is early game, he wants to probably use his Lightning Bolts and Chains to kind of get the creatures off of his back. So in this case, the Thralls, the cheap Thralls, kind of kill them early game, or maybe play a Disharmony, let them kill each other or sack, gain some life, you know, maybe get even some ramping going in City of Shadows. And then mid game, late game, he wants to take over the game by really throwing out his huge, big, beautiful creature threats, or maybe just a big fireball to win the game. So I think that's what my opponent wants to do. This is the deck that he's playing with today. So I've called it Disharmony and Friends because of the Disharmony package and, of course, the big, beefy, cool creatures that he's playing, hence the name Disharmony and Friends. Let's just go to the games. Let's see if the Disharmony stuff is going to work out for him. Let's go to game number one. Game number one is about to begin here. I'm sitting on the left and my opponent Yup gets to start with his mono red brew. And now we are playing EC, so that means mana burn is a thing. Fallen Empire cards can be played. And you can play with four strip mines if you want to, of course. There is the first spell being cast is by my opponent Yup playing a Chain Lightning. I'm going down to 17 here. And let's see what I can do. Playing a second Swamp. Tapping two, will this be exactly him to Turek? Very good card, one of the stronger cards in the Fallen Empires expansion. And Yup will now have to discard two cards at random. And there we go, so there's a Shivan and a City of Shadows. And let's take a look, he's playing a Diamond Valley. And look at that, another Chain Lightning. Dropping down to 14 here, it looks like he's on the direct damage plan for this game. And what can I do? Can I find a basic land here? That's of course important, just to keep those land drops going. There is another Swamp, so I'm playing Mono Black of course, so only Swamps in my deck. And there's a Mindstep Thrall. The 2/2 summon Thrall, and when it attacks, I can also sacrifice it and force my opponent to discard three cards. But there is a Chain Lightning on the Thrall. So that's already the third Chain Lightning that my opponent has played out here. That's, in a way, that's also good news for me. At least he's down three chain lightnings. Let's see, three basic swamps. And playing one of the four strip mines that I play, deciding to take care of his Diamond Valley and playing a Basil Thrull. And the Basil Thrull is two black. It's a 1/2 creature, and I can sacrifice it for two black mana. So I kind of like the idea of playing a Basil Thrull in combination. Oh, look at this Chain Lightning number four here. And he's playing it on me. I'm going to go down to 11. And what I wanted to say is what I like about the Basil Thrull is kind of the synergy it has with, for example, Drain Life. So I can sack it for two extra damage to my opponent and two life to me, basically, because it gives you two black mana to use. And there is another black attacking here for one, it seems. So he's dropping to 19. Ooh, and there is a Breeding Pit. Now, Breeding Pit is an enchantment from Fallen Empires, one black and three to cast. And at the end of my turn, I get a Thrall token. So actually, I should get a Thrall token right now. Okay, there we see the tokens. It's an 0/1 Thrall token. And I have to pay two mana during my upkeep or else the Breeding Pit gets buried. And here we see the first token. My opponent just passing turn here, it seems. And what can I do? Attacking here for one. And of course, a well-known combo is Breeding Pit and Lord of the Pit, because every turn you get a Thrall token that can get eaten by the Lord of the Pit. But right now, they're just 0/1 tokens and they're not doing too much. There is a safe haven from my opponent, Land from the Dark. And there's an attack again by the Basil Thrall, so he's dropping down here to 17. And there is a Lightning Bolt. Also on my life total, I'm already on 8. And he's played 4 Chain Lightnings and 1 Lightning Bolt so far. Hasn't played a single creature. And there is his first creature, the Rock Hydra. And it's coming in as a 1/1. You've got to pay 2 red and X. And each mana that you pay for X, that's the amount of +1/+1 counters, the amount of heads that are being placed on the Rock Hydra. So now it's just a 1/1. Very small Hydra. And finding another strip mine. And there is a Chaos Orb. And I'm actually gonna flip here. Interesting. I wonder on what I'm going to flip, actually. Am I gonna flip on the Rock Hydra? And there's the flip. It's a nice hit. And yes, it's on the Rock Hydra. Interesting choice here, because it doesn't seem to be a big problem. But I'm still doing it, not using my strip mine, which I think is a little mistake, because my opponent at the moment only has 3 lands that I can actually give him mana. So he's pretty low on land, so why not just keep him low on land? But maybe I've got a card for 5 that I want to cast, so maybe I want to use the land. But look at this. Another basic swamp attacking again for just 1. And just passing turn here, I'm not using my strip mine. And here we see an Ali from Cairo, I believe an 0/1 creature from the Arabian Nights. And the cool thing about this is it reads that your life total cannot go below 1. So it means that if you want to win the game, you will have to take care of the Ali from Cairo. And there is another Hymn to Turek, meaning my opponent loses his last card. Oh, that's really cool. It's a Phoenix. It's a Red Phoenix from Legends. It's a really cool card. Anyway, attacking again, and my Basil Thrall is doing some work, but this is really kind of a weird game because I'm only attacking with my 1/2 Basil Thrall. And look at this, another Rock Hydra. So that's going to be a 2/2. And my opponent isn't really doing much because I keep forcing him to discard all his cards. So that's kind of my fault. And I'm on 8 because of all the Chain Lightnings and Lightning Bolts. So, yeah, kind of a strange game here. In the meanwhile, though, my Breeding Pit is doing some work. I've now got 5 0/1 Thrall tokens, but what can I really do with them? I need a Bat Moon or some way to use these tokens. I've got a lot of mana, though, so maybe I can just hard cast the Lord of the Pit. That would have been, that would be pretty sweet, actually. Tapping four here. There is a drain life on the Rock Hydra. Interesting. Gaining some life, going back to 10, attacking again. Remember, at a certain point, I will have to deal with the Ali from Cairo because my opponent cannot go down down to zero while that Ali from Cairo is still on the board. Untapping here. What can I do? Playing another basic swamp, attacking. It's going to drop down to 12, so... Man, I've never seen such an aggressive Basil Thrall in my life. Usually they're kind of like useless. This is the nice Christopher Rush art, by the way. I think it's the nicest, the best art of all the Basil Thralls. The art in Fallen Empires in general has a really high quality. So if you've got some Fallen Empire cards, take some time to enjoy the art. It's really, really good art. Some of the best artists in the history of Magic the Gathering have worked on that set. Oh, this is cool. This is a soul exchange, and this is really cool, and I can sack one of my thralls from the breeding pit, and then bring back the mind step thrall. And the cool thing here is if you sacrifice a thrall with soul exchange, it gets a +2/+2 counter being placed on it. So that means I now have a 4/4 thrall to attack with. That is pretty cool. And my opponent here having three cards, simply passing turn again. And what is going to happen here? Attacking with both the Basil Thrall and the 4/4. What's going to happen? Is he just going to take the damage? He's got the Ali from Cairo, so he's pretty safe. But it is risky to just completely only play on the Ali from Cairo card. So it looks like he is taking the damage. That means 5 damage. So he's going to drop down to 6 life. And oh, look at this. Using the desert to deal 1 damage to my 4/4 thrall and a lightning bolt to kill the mind step thrall here. That is nice magic. This is pretty cool to see here, and I've actually seen another player doing this where he said, you know, I play with deserts with my bolts because then it can kill a Sarah Angel, and I think that's pretty cool. And here we see the little book from the Antiquities, and you can pay 2, then discard a card and draw a card. There's another Mindstep Thrall, and my opponent here on 5, Yup is on 5 life. But I need to get rid of the Ali from Cairo. 5 mana. Ooh, wow. 2-headed giant, a 4/4 trample, and it can block 2 creatures, actually, which is kind of relevant. So that is a problem. Another Mindstep Thrall. Look at the amount of little Thrall tokens I have there. I've got 10-01 Thrall tokens. And there he goes. He's going to discard a card and then, or draw a card and then discard a card. So first he gets to draw and then discard. Discards a Stone Rain. Not very useful at this point in the game. And playing another Mountain. And deciding not to attack, of course. This is very interesting. Am I gonna just attack with everything? What am I gonna do? Looks like putting my Basil Thrall there separately. Okay, that's why I'm playing another Mindstep Thrall. The thing is, the two-headed giant has 2 heads, so it can block 2 creatures. So even if I attack with all 4, it can block 2 of my thralls. It will probably go for the Basil Thrall and the Mindstep Thrall, and just kill both, and then the giant will actually survive as well. And as long as my opponent has it Ali from Cairo, it's actually all good. Doesn't have to worry that much. And it looks like I'm starting to using dice now. And I've got 11 of those 01 tokens. There is a fireball. I wonder what he's going to aim it at. Probably at my life total. That would make most sense. He would half my life. Actually, he's killing two of my mindstep thralls. So maybe he wants to play a little bit more aggressive. And you can see he doesn't want to lean too much on his Ali from Cairo, which I can understand because it's not protected or anything. If I can just kill the Ali from Cairo, then his protection is gone as well. But for now, he's still on 5 life. I'm on 10 life. And in all honesty, I think, you know, if you're a burn player, you're not too unhappy about the current scenario. Wow! Shivan Dragon! This is a big problem for me here. What can I do? Oh, man. And next turn, he can actually kill me with a Shivan one strike. And it's nice that I've got all these breathing pit tokens, but it's not really going to help me, is it? Wow, wow, wow. It is looking bad. I'm already looking at my cards. Ooh, I think I'm toast. Literally toast, because the Shivan is going to attack here. And wow. Nice victory. Or do I have something like a terror in hand or something else to deal with the Shivan dragon? Attacking here with the Shivan. Bumping it up to 10. And yeah, that's it. That's it. Congratulations, Yoop, on this first game win. There was a drain life, but that was also not going to really help me much. We'll take care of the Shivan at least. But yeah, wow. I felt like I kind of had the upper hand, but I couldn't put any pressure on the board. So this is a first game win for my opponent for the mono red deck. Let's go into our sideboards and we'll catch back up with this game in game number two. Game number two. And okay, I'm behind. So come on, Thrall Army. I really felt in game one that I had control, like I did what I wanted to do, force my opponent to discard a lot of cards so he couldn't really play out any threats and then kind of dominate the board. But I just couldn't find the right thralls. No Thrall Champion, nothing. No Lord of the Pit, nothing. And I couldn't just put pressure on, and I kind of gave my opponent an opening, you know, to play his bigger creatures, because that's basically what my opponent wants to do. While we see a quick chain here by the mono red player, so he basically wants to drag the game into mid game, late game, so he can deploy his bigger creatures, Shivan Dragons, two-headed giants, Rock Hydras, play huge fireballs. And there we see a lightning bolt on the mindstep thrall, by the way. So again, we see a lot of chains and bolts early on from my opponent, which kind of helps him to control the board and kind of drag the game into mid game. And let's see, he's gonna tap three here. Oh, this is nice. Wheel of Fortune. That means we're both gonna discard our hands there. Oh, did you see that? I'm actually discarding a Mind Twist and we're drawing seven new cards. And well, at least I get to start now with a full grip of cards, and I'm gonna draw card number eight. So that's actually pretty good. So untapping my three swamps, drawing another one, or at least another card. Don't know if it's a swamp. Let's see what I can do. Tapping one black, casting a soul ring. I can still play out a land this turn. Am I in the tank a little bit perhaps, because I've got a full grip here. So probably have tons of options. Hopefully I can put some pressure on the board here, because my opponent is still on 20. And he can start deploying serious threats when he's up to 5 mana. Playing a Mindstep Thrall here. So again, the 2-2. I'm seeing a lot of Mindstep Thralls this game. I'm not sure if I'm really happy about that. I mean, it's a nice creature, but you know, I want to draw more than just Mindstep Thralls. Okay, and here we see the Diamond Valley, the card from Arabian Nights. And what it does, you can tap it to sack a creature and you gain life equal to the toughness. Very strong land. You can do a lot of crazy shenanigans with it. Attacking here, let's see what my opponent is going to do. Oh, look at this! There's a Disharmony! Oh, That's really cool to see this card. What it does, it's from Legends, and you can basically take over a creature from your opponent. And so he's taking over my Mindstep Thrall, and this is a really nice combo that we see here, by the way. He's taking over my Mindstep Thrall, and when it's in his control, he's sacking it to the Diamond Valley, because with Disharmony, at the end of the turn, all the creature goes back to the owner, which is me, so I would get it back, but I don't get it back now, because Yup has sacked it to his Diamond Valley, so now he's taken over my creature, so he's taken no damage, and he gains 2 life, because he's sacrificed it to the Diamond Valley. So pretty nice. And of course, after that, because I'm just a mediocre player, I'm playing the Strip Mine. So I could have played the Strip Mine before stripped his Diamond Valley. Anyway, decide not to. Look at this play, playing a Lord of the Pit, a 7/7 flying trample. But of course, you know, with the Lord of the Pit, I have to sacrifice a creature to it. It wants to eat during the upkeep, but I have no creatures because I just lost my Mindstep Thrall. So that means that I'll probably have to take 7 damage. So I would go down to 10. So what I'm doing is pretty risky, because I'm playing against a player with direct damage, of course. Let's see what he's going to do now. Maybe he even has a solution for the Lord of the Pit. Plays a mountain, goes through his hands, looking at his options. His hand, I should say, looking at his option. What can he do? Maybe he's fine with me dropping to 10 and taking 7 for himself. I mean, he's on 22. And look at this. He's playing a Dragon Whelp 2/3 flyer that you can pump for 1 red for +1/+0. And you cannot pump it more than 3. So you cannot make it bigger than a 5/3. This is kind of a problem because I'm down now to 10. And it looks like I'm destroying... Am I destroying the Diamond Valley? Or maybe I should just go for the red lands here. No, I'm going for the Diamond Valley. Attacking here with the 7/7. He's probably just going to take the damage, dropping to 15. But look at my life total. I'm on 10. I need to play a creature here. And, ooh, I'm playing a Soul Exchange. I'm kind of forced to do this because I don't want to take 7 damage next turn. And now my Mindstep Thrall is not getting a +2/+2 bonus because I'm not sacrificing a Thrall with the Soul Exchange. I'm sacrificing my Lord of the Pit. Now, obviously, this is not what I want to do. This is why I'm playing with a Breeding Pit, because I want to sacrifice an 0/1 Thrall to get, for example, my Lord of the Pit back. Unfortunately, it looks like I'm just not drawing the cards in the right order, and I'm kind of forced to make these mediocre plays. And, I mean, I can take 5 damage now from the Dragon Whelp, and I'm thinking maybe I should have used my Strip Mine on the other mountain and not on the Diamond Valley. Maybe use both of them to take care of 2 mountains, because then he would be really low on land. I think that was kind of a misplay on my part. Let's see what he can do now. Tapping 3 here. Is he going to cast, for example, a Gargoyle? Granite Gargoyle, 2/2 flyer for 3? Yeah, there we see it. Granite Gargoyle. And it's looking really bad for me. I mean, he can swing for 4. He can also decide to just swing for 3 and then keep 1 mountain open or not pump at all. Wow. This is not good. This is not good. Tapping 2 here. Demonic Tutor, okay. Maybe I have something. What am I going to do here? Play a Drain Life? Nah, I don't think so. I can only play a Drain Life for 2, so that wouldn't really make sense. Sengir Vampire? I don't think it's... No, it's not in my deck. What can I do? I'm not sure, but I guess I played it for a reason. Maybe play a Soul Exchange? Get Lord of the Pit back? Do I want to? I mean, I'm on 8. Lord of the Pit is going to hurt me more. Going to get me to 1 the next turn. This is a difficult situation. I wonder what card I picked. Am I playing with Nevernurl's Disc in this deck? I don't think so. There is another Strip Mine attacking here. And he's going to block. Doesn't really seem to bother me much. paying four. Okay. Oh, this is a pretty cool play. So using my Dark Ritual and my Pestilence kind of as a board wipe here, that does mean I'm taking three damage. Actually, yeah, three, right? Not four. So I'm going down to five. My opponent's on 12. Actually, this is not too bad. I'm kind of impressed with this player from my side. Being able to wipe the board and stay alive at least for one more turn. I mean, I'm on five and playing against a direct damage player. I know maybe he's got a double chain in hand, then I'm dead. But you got to play towards your outs. And I think this was a decent play. If he has a fireball and a lightning bolt and a chain, I'm dead now anyway. There is a strip mine by my opponent. Tapping four, another dragon whelp. Oh, cool. Aladdin is a card from the Arabian Nights, and you can tap it and you can take over an artifact. So it's not super relevant, but he can take over my soul ring. It's pretty cool. The nice thing about Aladdin's lamp is it doesn't have to remain tapped. So that's pretty cool. And there's a Thrall champion. Okay. Oh man, it gives all Thralls +1/+1, including itself. So I think it's now a 3/3 for 5 mana. Yeah. And you can also tap it, by the way, to take over a Thrall from the opponent if it has a Thrall. But that doesn't happen often. I think we're discussing that now. It's just hilarious. It's the only Lord in Fallen Empires. So it's quite interesting. And it's got that anthem effect, which is quite valuable, giving all the Thralls +1/+1. And obviously, I want to have Breeding Pit right next to my Thrall champion. I'm just happy that I'm still in this game, to be honest, after a Pestilence play. Passing turn here. Let's see if my opponent is now going to use the Aladdin to take over my Soul Ring. That would be pretty sweet. There is a City of Shadows. And let's see. Is he gonna... Yep. Looks like he's gonna take over the Soul Ring. So I guess he has to pay not just tap, but also pay two red and one for the Aladdin to work. And now he's kind of attacking my mana base, and he's doing it quite successfully with that strip mine as well. That means I just lost three manas, which is not great. Playing another land, swinging in here for three, I believe. That means he's gonna drop to nine. But I need to play more. I cannot just wait and see what's going to happen. Remember, my opponent now has five mana because he's got my Soul Ring. And five, I mean, that's enough to start playing some scary stuff. And I think he's that is the Soul Ring that's actually on my side. So he's using that just to clarify it for us. And if he draws into another land and a fireball, I'm also dead. He can just play a fireball of five, by the way. Because City of Shadows cannot make mana. Well, it can, but not by itself. You first need to sack a creature to the City of Shadows. Tapping one red. Will there be... Yeah, of course, a chain. Oh, on my Thrall Champion. So Thrall Champion is dead. Gonna attack with my Aladdin, with his Aladdin. I guess it's a 1-1. I thought it was an 0-2, but it's a 1-1. So going down to 4 life here. Is the Aladdin gonna kill me here? Is that what's going to happen? Tapping 3. Okay, playing the book. Gonna go down to 3 here. Still has enough land also to activate the little book. It's not doing it. Of course, another Mindstep Thrall, because why not? Why not? I've really seen enough Mindstep Thralls for a lifetime, I think. But hey, at least it's a 2-2. It keeps the Aladdin from my back. Untapping here. Playing land number 6. Deciding not to attack. End step using the book. Discarding the Shatter, that makes sense with the Aladdin. You want to steal artifacts, not destroy them. What else can I do here? What is my opponent going to do, I should say, because it's his turn. He's passing or not? He's passing turn as well. So I've got two cards in hand at the moment. Attacking it with the 2-2, so that probably means that I drew into a creature. Oh, again a Disharmony. And he's going to sack it now to his City of Shadows. Oh, man. Oh, these Disharmonies. And that means he's got like a Shadow counter, and I believe he can now tap it for one mana. And I'm playing a Basil Thrall. It's just hilarious. Like this, I mean, my Mindstep Thralls have been of zero use in both of these games. At least they're eating up Disharmonies and Lightning Bolts and Chain Lightning, so it could be worse. Basil Thrall, the 1-2 creature now from my side of the table. Passing turn. And now City of Shadows is good to tap for one mana because of that one counter. And he's counting his lands. I'm dead, or there's a Shivan, and I'm dead next turn. Yeah, there's a Shivan. Oh, man, this is not good. Please give me a terror or something. No, there's a dark ritual, and I think, yeah, I'm pretty dead. Showing him two dark rituals in hand, and he even had a lightning bolt. Wow, wow, wow. Congratulations, Yup. What a cool victory, man. You killed me twice with the Shivan Dragon. I mean, I gotta respect that, and I think I need to get back to the drawing board with my Thrall deck. Or I just need some more luck. You know, I have bad luck, man. You gotta admit it. I mean, I just drew the cards in the wrong order. If that Lord of the Pit would have gone, if I would have drawn it later in the game, it would have been much, much better. Anyway, thank you for watching another episode of Timmy Talks, the channel where we talk old school magic. And on what other channel can you see somebody getting his ass kicked by two Shivan Dragons? I mean, how cool is that? I'm happy. If I die, then let me die. Let me die from a huge creature, huge iconic creature like the Shivan Dragon. If you want to support the channel, you can do that by liking this video. If you haven't done that yet, it's really appreciated. Leaving a comment, let me know what you think of these games. Would you like to build one of those kick-ass red decks yourself? I'm sure you would, because I want to do that now after playing this game. Let me know what you think about my Thrall deck. What is your impression of Mindstep Thrall? Oh, man. Anyway, you can also support the channel financially. You can become a patron, on Patreon. There's probably a card popping up right now. You can click on the link and you can already support the channel starting at $1 a month, and I would really appreciate it. So you can have a look and you can check out what Timmy Talks does on Patreon. And we actually do quite a lot. We organize tournaments, we do competitions, we've got a Discord. So it's all good. It's all good and fun. So have a look if that interests you. Talking about Patreon, let's take a look at the fantastic, amazing, cool patrons of Timmy Talks.
What shall we do with the drunken sailor? What shall we do with the drunken sailor? What shall we do with the drunken sailor?
Zumba Kazee!